Before the video starts, I need to give you a bit of context, because you're probably wondering, how did an 18-year-old kid who just graduated high school end up working a robotics engineering job in China? Well, a few months ago, I was just trying to find a summer part-time job back in the US, but everywhere I looked, it was the same story. You need a college degree. And I didn't have any of it. So I had an idea. What if I just applied overseas? I figured, screw it, let's try. A few interviews later, I landed a mechanical engineering role at a robotics company in Shenzhen, working on actual humanoids. And yeah, this summer, I flew across the world to start building robots. I try to wake up at around 4 to 5, and the first thing I do is to wash up, and then I head to the gym for about an hour. I've been trying to fix my sleep schedule during this trip back to China and stay healthy while doing it. After that, I usually work on a video for my robotics channel.
Alright, and here's the fit. It's pretty nice.
Now it's time for breakfast. And honestly, the hotel breakfast here is actually really good. So that's nice. Next, it's time to walk to work. I'm based here in Yuribot's biggest testing facility here in Shenzhen, China. And I actually live really, really close to where I work, so it's about a 5-minute walk.
And really weird, because every single like taxi I've gotten in so far has been an EV. So, kind of drowns out the sound that you kind of usually hear when you're in the US, right? Now we're inside the facility. I would work over there next to like the overseas department. And yeah, there's a lot of robots here that all kind of work in the silicon kind of manufacturing chip industry here. And there's some humanoids that I'm gonna be working on later on, but I'll be showing you.
I'm on the humanoids team and I've been working on a brand new arm and hand for it. Last week was kind of busy. I had to basically speedrun learning SolidWorks in one day since everything had to be CADded in that. I started by sketching a bunch of linkage ideas on paper just to get my thoughts before spending hours modeling something that wouldn't work. I went through a bunch of designs. Some of the linkages ended up being too weak and I eventually landed on one that made sense and I sent it out to manufacturing over the weekend. We're using the Inspire hand for this design and it's about $11,000, so definitely can't be messing this up. And today's the fun part. The shipment should be arriving later today and we'll be attaching the Inspire hand to the arm and onto the actual humanoid. Usually for lunch there's a lot of options, but today I'm gonna go back to the hotel to just take a nap because there's gonna be a lot of work I still need to do later. After the nap, I walked back to the facility and I got hit by a surprise. One of our older humanoids just came back from shipping and they got completely messed up. The neck joint was completely wrecked during transport and the head was literally bent at this super weird angle. Definitely not usable. So first thing, we opened it up, we took the front plate and back plates off, and yeah, the neck connector had fully snapped. But luckily, it only broke on the side that already had screws in it. The front side was still clean, no screws had ever gotten there. So we figured, why not try adding new screws on that clean side and see if we can get it working again. And after a whole lot of elbow grease, we got it. The neck was fixed, the robot booted back up, and we're back on track. Next up is shipping. We had to send this robot to Wuhan, China, where it will be on display for another big robotics show. We wrapped every part of the robot in protective film and built a custom wooden crate around it and secured that with straps. Once everything was locked in place, we sealed it up and labeled it for transport. And right after we loaded the robot to be sent to Wuhan, the new robotic arm that I designed finally arrived.
It's finally time to put it on. The hand will be pressed into the grooves on the arm, making an airtight seal. Originally, I left about 1 millimeter of clearance in the design, but thanks to 3D printing tolerances, the fit came out to be perfect and super tight.
It works, and look, that's the hand. And we have successfully designed it and it arrived.
Once the hand was pressed in firmly, I secured it with 4 screws in the holes I built into it on the CAD model.
And even though shipping took a long time, it looks like everything lines up well. And it looks like our job here is done. Look at that.
Then we brought the hand over to the humanoid testing area, where I attached the forearm to the rest of the arm using the 6 mounting holes I added in the CAD. It was a little tricky to line everything up just right, but after some patience, I was able to screw it in perfectly.
Okay, now the new arm is facing the same way as the old one. You can see it kind of has a very natural degree of motion, and yeah, we're gonna have to kind of pick up stuff later on.
After wrapping up at work, I clocked out at around 6 p.m. My mom and I headed to one of Shenzhen's ancient towns. We soaked in the vibes, the stone alleys, and the traditional architecture. And I even grabbed boba at a local stall.
We're here at one of the ancient towns here, which has been repurposed for kind of visitors and just like tourist attractions. And you can see it's very pretty.
And then we ended the evening with traditional Chinese dinner at one of the local restaurants. And yeah, that's pretty much wraps for my day as an engineer.